Hey Qlikies, ready to take your data analytics to the next level? Meet the Decomposition Tree in Qlik Sense. It visually breaks down your totals across multiple dimensions, empowering you to slice and dice your metrics as you please and conduct root cause analysis like a boss. Stick around, and I'll show you how to easily add these visuals to your dashboards. Creating decomposition trees in Qlik Sense is completely intuitive and takes just 4 simple steps. Without further ado, let's get started. First of all, head to qlik.anychart.com and grab the decomposition tree extension for Qlik Sense. Then, install it into your Qlik environment. Simply follow the instructions in the corresponding README file in the extension archive, depending on whether you are using Qlik Sense Enterprise, Qlik Sense Desktop, or Qlik Sense Cloud. If you are starting fresh, click on Create New App in the hub. Name it. Click Create. And open it. Next, add your data to the app. Simply click on Add Data from Files and Other Sources. If you've got a CSV file, simply browse and select it from the local system. Now it's time to add the Decomposition Tree extension to your Qlik Sense app. Here's how. On the sheet where you want to add a decomposition tree, click on Edit Sheet to enter the edit mode. In the pane, open Custom Objects, locate the AnyChart Decomposition Tree extension, and drop it onto your canvas. Boom! You've got an empty decomposition tree chart in front of you, and you're all set to bring it to life with just a few more clicks. Now, select a measure to disaggregate and add dimensions for a breakdown. For that, you can use the respective buttons. Or navigate to the Data tab in the Properties panel on the right side of the screen. You can choose at least one measure and at least one dimension to break it down. Feel free to edit the way the dimensions and measures are labeled in the visualization if needed. Once you've done all that, click Done Editing in the top right corner, and there you go. You'll see a picture like this, meaning your decomposition tree visualization is basically ready and waiting for your questions. Your metric is the root element. To explore the breakdown, hover over the root element, click on the plus sign next to the value bar, and choose a dimension to dive deeper. This reveals the major contributors within that dimension. Repeat this process for other elements and dimensions you want to explore further. As you see, you don't even have to worry about selecting the order of dimensions up front, because you've got the power to arrange them as you go thanks to the magical Flex Dimensions feature. This makes the decomposition tree an ideal tool for ad-hoc data exploration. Drill down into any different dimensions and uncover insights in a fluid and dynamic manner. You can customize your Qlik Sense decomposition tree in multiple ways, and it's also easy and intuitive. Simply go to the edit mode and browse the properties panel on the right to find and tweak whatever you need. Now, let's delve into some customization options you may like to use. When there are too many elements, you can enable paging. In the Properties panel, go to Appearance, Presentation, and check the Limit Items per Column box. This setting ensures that only screen-fitting elements appear. Hidden elements remain accessible through vertical paging with arrow controls and by clicking triple dots. Use the Min Items per Column slider to set the minimum number of elements displayed on each level according to your preferences. When analyzing, use arrow controls for paging up or down. By default, the Flex Dimensions feature is enabled, bringing ad-hoc exploration to life. But there are situations where you may prefer to fix the order of dimensions. For example, for explanatory purposes. To do that, in the Properties panel, go to Appearance, Presentation, and uncheck the respective box named Use Flex Dimension, and arrange the desired order of the dimensions in the Data section. In this way, the viewers will follow that predefined path as they explore. By default, the length of the value bars is calculated relative to the maximum value per level, allowing you to compare values within each level. But you can change that. In the Properties panel, go to Appearance, Presentation, and from there, you can choose your desired calculation method using the drop-down menu. There are two more options available. First, the bar length can be relative to the parent value, which helps to analyze contributions to the parent element. Second, it can be relative to the root element, providing insights into contributions to the total. You can also easily modify the colors of bars in the Decomposition Tree visualization to make the look consistent with your brand, highlight specific patterns, and so on. In the Properties panel, go to Appearance. Colors. Set the bar color toggle to Custom. And from there, you have the option to set static colors, color by measure, or apply conditional coloring, color by expression, based on specific criteria. Customization possibilities for your decomposition tree in Qlik Sense are quite endless. You can add multiple measures and easily switch between them in the Analyze mode. You can also hide dimension column headers. Reshape to a compact view or a wide view. And do much more. Feel free to explore all the various options for customization in the Properties panel. If you need further assistance, head over to the Decomposition Tree documentation, qlik.anychart.com. And feel free to send your questions to support@anychart.com, if any. So, what are you waiting for? Grab the Decomposition Tree extension by AnyChart, Qlik's technology partner, and enjoy the new heights of data exploration in Qlik Sense.